Missouri and what you know about them?
Well, obviously they're a great shooting team, making 18 threes against Auburn. You know, I think 47% of their combined shots, you know, during their season has been threes, and so we understand that, and they're a little bit different than the previous two SEC teams that we've played, and so they're going to be a great challenge for us.
Taber Morgan, I went 11 of 18 from the
yes,
arc. You could appreciate that, can't
mm-hmm.
you?
Absolutely. I mean, that's obviously great shooting, and, you know, that's what they lend themselves to do, and we have great respect for their shooters, and we're really going to have to be on it and really ID them wherever they are.
You went 38 minutes, I think, in the other game. A lot of players' minutes are going up right mm-hmm. now. How are you guys dealing with that?
Well, I mean, a lot of it is we feel in great shape. We feel like, you know, preseason and everything's really helped us get our conditioning up, and, you know, also the coaches are just being smart, understanding that we are down, you know, in numbers a little bit right now with Sierra out. And so, you know, it's all about recovery. It's all about, you know, just doing what you need to do to be able to be out on the floor.
Being shorthanded and still the success, you know, on the road at South Carolina and then here, you know, against Georgia, were you surprised with just how much, or I guess this final score, how much y'all beat them by?
I don't think we're surprised. Honestly, we respect all of those teams. They're really great teams, very athletic teams, and, you know, every game in the SEC is going to be tough. But for us, we just want to keep getting better every single game and play, you know, to our potential. And so we felt like we were finally, you know, reaching those in the second half. And so the score is going to take care of itself. We're not really focused on that. We're just focusing on trying to improve.
What does it take for you guys to come out from the tip and have a little bit more spark? Holly joked that she had to open up the bottle on you guys. Does Holly need to open up before the tip? Is it between the players that you think within you guys you can come out faster?
Well, definitely I think it's on us as the players. You know, coaches shouldn't have to motivate us to especially start a game out. And so, you know, I think the defensive intensity that we've seen in the second half of both of these games needs to be implemented into the first half. And, you know, our defense is really creating kind of our offense and getting us kind of into a flow of things. So we just really need to focus on, you know, playing defensively for 40 minutes, and hopefully that'll fix our problem.
Do you remember any time in your career you've played a team that relies on the three quite as much as you guys
do? I don't know. Looking back, there's different shooters, and honestly, a lot of this team is a lot like Chattanooga, and obviously no one wants to think back to that game, but, you know, they're great shooters, and any time you live and die by the three, you can always be in a game, and so we're going to have to understand that, and you know, really attack that. And like I said, everybody's going to have to know where everybody is on the floor.
Talk about the success of this team so far. I mean, across the country and across the SEC, you guys lose the starters that you lost from last year. Pat's not here, new mm-hmm. coaching staff, everything. You guys have just kind of picked it up right where Tennessee women's basketball usually is. Just talk about that.
Yeah, well, honestly, we feel a sense of pride about, you know, continuing the legacy that Coach has left us. And obviously, you know, we always hopefully are going to recruit talented players being at Tennessee and the tradition that we have. And we feel like Holly is very capable and she's done a great job with this team, and we've really bought into our system, and everyone's just kind of stepped up in their own way. And so, you know, I know maybe people across the country are surprised, but honestly, we're not really focusing on that, and we can't look at the outside factors because we know, you know, we lost to Baylor, we lost to Stanford, and those are the teams that we want to be able to play with and hopefully, you know, be down the stretch, and so that's really where we want to be.
Talk about Holly and the job that she's done. I mean, she kind of, they were saying how last year she was the cool coach.
Yeah.
Now she's the 8C, and she's getting on you guys, opening up the can of Holly in the
yeah.
you know, locker room. Just talk about that change.
Well, I mean, obviously when you have that head coach title, you do have to change a little bit, and you know, Holly's still that, you know, great, you know, friend, gonna be there for you, wanna know how you're doing, build a relationship with you kind of coach. But I've definitely seen her step it up and put the, you know, kind of, you know, challenge us a lot more. And honestly, that's what you look for in a head coach. And so I think she's made that transition well, and she's, you know, embracing it. So.
Do you think the problem at first, though, was that you guys weren't taking her seriously because she was that friend to you guys last year?
You know, obviously there's a transition period, and things are different. And whenever you have you lose a head coach, things are going to be a little bit different. Even though she's been in our program for 27 years, I mean, it's still a different person at the top. And so I think it was more of just us adjusting to her coaching style. And, you know, we had to build trust with one another. You know, she had to trust us, and we had to trust her as a head coach. And I feel like we've definitely reached that point.
How much have you seen Izzy grow from last year to this year? And Were you working out with her during the summers and during the off season?
Well, honestly, ever since she came in, we all the players knew that she had this potential, and we've seen it. We saw it day in and day out in practice. And, you know, when you play behind Vicky Baugh, Lori Johnson, two players that get drafted, you know, very high in the WNBA draft, that's kind of hard to get minutes. They're just going to be limited. And so I think we all knew that she had this potential, and she's worked hard in the offseason. And so I'm glad for her that she's, you know, getting that payoff right now. Well, honestly, I'm not sure. We're going to look at tape right now, but I think I know a little bit names and, you know, familiar with probably faces and stuff, but I knew a lot more of them previously in years previous, but not so much this year.
Big picture, coaches tell players not to look too far ahead, but big picture, how far can this team go to reach the goals that Tennessee women's basketball typically achieves?
Well, honestly, we don't want to put any limits on ourselves, and we believe that this team can reach, you know, all the goals that we want to, but our goals aren't really on that right now. We're trying to every day get better, and we can't look at March. We can't look at even, you know, a great challenge in Notre Dame, a number two team in the country at the end of the month. We can't look at that. We have to look at every single day, and, you know, Missouri's our next opponent, and so if we can take that approach, I think this team can be special.